So an anchor is the portion of a fall protection system that you actually use to attach to the structure or whatever it's you're going to use to support your weight in case you fall. Typically the type that we had typically used were the flat style anchors you could nail down to the top of a roof. And it basically has a nail plate, certain number of holes, you have to fill all of them up for depending on what type of system you're using. We've also seen anchor systems where they bridge several trusses. Things like that that can be positioned around, moved a lot easier. Another type of anchor that I kind of wanted to talk about was the permanent anchors. And you can find these anchors for about $20 to $25. And the idea is they go underneath the ridge cap on a roof. So as your roofers are going up, they put this anchor in place and then cover it over with the roof cap. And that anchor stays there for the life of the roof. So that if anybody, including the homeowner, has to get up on the roof, they already have something set in place to tie off to.
The anchors that we use the most are depending on the job we're at. And so I just finished a indoor gas station with 70 pump heads and 16 car washes. That was only two stories tall. And so there we used a mobile set of tie-off anchors, which actually rolled around and had a weighted system in there. And so it worked off friction. And so we could take it to the edge and then people would be tied off that way.
The most popular type of anchor is either gonna be a mechanical one, like a wedge anchor, where you drill a hole and then there's a mechanical way for that to tighten up. It has engineering behind it. My favorite is cast-in anchors. Not only do you have the anchor and the pull-out of the threads of the bolt that you're using, but you have, you know, all the concrete there as well.
At this building, we use anchorage to attach our linear ropes for our harnesses, and it's set up on a roof. Each ridge of the roof has anchorage in there. And this particular building was already pre-installed, but we verified it was installed correctly, because you don't want it to have somebody mistakenly install just over plywood and it will just rip right off. You want to make sure there's a solid frame and on both sides has the proper fasteners. So you don't want it just to kind of in and install it. So, and that's what they tell all the guys too. If you guys have a rope hanging from the roof, you gotta go make sure that's installed. You don't wanna just, what if somebody just left it, you know, proper procedure, make sure it's hooked up properly, tested it, you know, talk to your supervisor, you know, supervisor has to verify it so everybody knows, okay, green light, you can go ahead and use it. So yes, if it's not set up, it's, everything is worthless. So yes, it starts from the top, make sure it's properly attached, make sure a rope is properly attached, and obviously, you know, hey, it could have been old building or it could have been rusted out. So maybe there was a time to replace it. So want to make sure that it has good condition, and you want to verify, we actually talked to who installed it as well. So make sure it was done correctly, and they also talked to the management company verifying that everything was done properly, and so we can go ahead and safely use it.
Common anchorage points in residential construction. A lot of times we'll see people tying off to the peak as far as putting an anchor nailed to the sheeting on the peak of the roof. We've also seen the straps nailed to the floor, typically used with the self-retracting lifeline styles. There's ones that span across several trusses for anchors. One common one we'll see that obviously isn't approved is people will wrap their rope around the peak of the truss, around the rafters, and it's like, I get that that may handle that weight, but it's not rated for that, and you don't truly know if it will. So, and actually, there's a leave-in anchor as well that can be used for the attic that you basically nail to the side of the peak of the trusses, and this provides an anchor point for if you're gonna be working in the attic or, say, above a stairwell.
Anytime we need to tie off, there needs to be a positive anchorage point. The most common for us is either a screw down or a nail down plate with the steel loop on that. There are situations where if we get the engineer's approval, we can tie off to a piece of steel or even a truss if needed, but that does need to be approved by the engineer to carry the load.
Well, you always want to make sure that you're fastening through the decking into the members below, the framing members. So the nails are going to clearly indicate, and you're gonna feel as you're fastening your anchor points. You're gonna feel as you're fastening if you're going through plywood only, that's called a shiner, and it's not doing anything. But if you hit resistance as you're driving the nail in, or we use screws, then you know your roof mount is attached properly. And I call it a roof mount, but in this context, it would be a floor mount. But it's an elevated, it's like a gun turret, and it just rotates 360 degrees so that the retractable yo-yo or whatever you want to call it is facing you. And every time you walk, you know, it's paying out your fall protection. And as you walk back, it'll suck it back in. Hedge your bet towards safety. There's always a way to be safe, and you can tie off above yourself and you can roll joist. And the moment you've got a couple of joists rolled or a beam rolled, then you have something you can mount, one of those roof mounts, and then you're able to work a certain radius. And then again, you do another one so that as you keep going, you put another retractable or you put something so that the person can keep working and not exceed horizontally the vertical drop. Because at that point, you're wasting your time. You might look good to a compliance officer driving by, but that defeats the purpose, because in the end, you're only cheating yourself, you know, or your crew members by allowing them to not be safe.
There are many of us that work inside or in other environments where we don't have a walking surface such as a roof or a substrate such as that. Take an iron worker or something similar to that where we have an exposed I-beam. Another common tool is a beam clamp or a beamer clamp that is designed to attach around multiple flanges merely by just squeezing that trigger and getting it around one side of the I-beam flange, bringing it up like that, and then you will just slide it in, connect, and then we would hang our retractable or put our lanyard to that, and then it would be suspended from the I-beam. Another very common, especially when we talk about exposed I-beams, angle iron, or even exposed columns, concrete columns, partially or fully poured, is what's called an anchor strap. This is an extremely useful, and they come in various lengths. Standard usually in the market is 3, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, and 20 feet, but many manufacturers can even make them of custom lengths depending on what we need to wrap this around. The nice thing of these is that they're very easy to install. The structural part is this black part where you can see where that's where the webbing is sewn in and the D-rings are, and the yellow backer part is that of a softener. So as you're wrapping it around something that has sharp or burred edges in the construction world, and you just choke it back around whatever anchor it's like that, and then you can hang your retractable from there. If you're using a horizontal lifeline, in many cases they can be used vertically this way, putting some tension in. The other benefit is that although it is as strong as it needs to be in this configuration, they are designed so that if necessary, you can do multiple wraps. Just make sure that it always pays through all of the way. That way you can get it the connection as close to the anchor or the structure as possible. Just make sure you get a full choke through. Make it line up, and then we got it tensioned and it will hold its position, and then we have a correct or a compatible connection for our anchor or lanyard to be connected. Any anchorage attachment, beam strap, or other device, it is still imperative that when we're on site, other than following the manufacturer's instructions, that we still have to verify that the structure that we affix this to isn't just something random, that it is still evaluated either by a competent person or by a qualified person. Laying one truss doesn't make it structurally sound, and at some points, no doubt, you will have to have somebody actually do engineering or prove that it is capable of withstanding the forces. We talked about working on top of a top plate and that the framing is up, but is it really an anchor? Can it sustain the loads applied in a dynamic fall from it pulling over? If the trusses, you only have two, and if we're all to the left side, will it pull everything over and just collapse like a house of cards? If I'm attached with an anchor such as this, and it's only attached to 26 gauge, and the manufacturer requires 12 gauge, depending on what it might be, then we know that it's not attached to something that will withstand the forces that it's designed to apply to the structure. So always be sure, not only do we select the right tool for the job, that we install and assure our workers install it the appropriate way in the appropriate place.